Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. And in today's video, we are going to talk about BITS Pilani. It's one of the most overhyped college in India. So today we have Pushpendra over here who will be helping us to know everything about the college. So let's get started. Hi Pushpendra.
Hi Sandhya.
How are you?
I'm good. I'm perfectly fine.
Okay. So could you please introduce yourself?
Yeah, so I am a student at BITS Pilani and I have a integrated degree there, and my degree is Masters of Science in Mathematics, and along with it I also pursue Bachelors of Engineering in Electronics and Instrumentation Engineering.
Oh, so I guess it's a course of 4 to 5 years, is that so?
It's a 5-year course because it's an integrated degree, and the college also offers 4-year courses, but those are mostly single degree options.
Okay, so let's start with the admission criteria. Like, how did you went into this college? Because I guess it's tough to be a part of this college. Not everyone can get into it. So I just want to know the overall, you know, hard work that you have done behind getting into this college. So let's talk about that.
So mostly like all the students who come to BITS Pilani don't prepare specifically for BITS. I hope so. I haven't prepared for it. So like the JE Mains is there, JE Advanced is there, and there is a paper called BITSET conducted by BITS for admission process. Okay, so the level of BITSET is comparable to JE Mains. So most of the people who are not able to score that much marks in JE Mains give BITSET as a backup option. So yeah, BITSET is the way you can get into BITS. Other than that, BITS also offers admission to the board toppers. The All India board toppers can also get admission in there.
Oh, I guess it's fancy then. But what were the subjects that you have prepared for
In JE Mains, basically physics, chemistry, maths is there. But in BITSET, at our time, there were some extra questions of reasonings and English. So physics, chemistry, maths was the most important portion. And then reasoning, some 10 to 15 questions of reasoning, then 10 questions of English. This was the paper. One more thing, BITSET also allow bio students to appear for the examination, because BITS Pilani offers B Pharma as well. So for B Pharma, the students who are from bio background can choose between maths or bio in the BITSET paper.
Okay, so now it's been 4 years, I guess, you know, since you are a part of this college. So how is the overall journey going? Like, do you think ki aur bhi better colleges the which you can opt for? And abhi tak ka overall experience kaisa raha hai? Just tell us about that.
So talking about the other option I had at my time, they were a lot. I was literally getting admission in every college of India, like all the IITs, NITs, everything. So this was my personal choice to come here because this was like close to my hometown. So that was the major thing behind coming to the BITS Pilani. Other than that, the college life was fun. So the first year was online due to the COVID, and we came to the campus after 3 semesters, I guess. So after 3 semesters, after being at home for 3 semesters, the college life started all of a sudden. The seniors were also not that much of introduced to the campus because they were also in the COVID phase. So yeah, we got good links with our seniors. We had fun roaming around the campus, having freedom for the first time after college life is fun. The campus of BITS Pilani is quite beautiful, so yeah.
You chose BITS Pilani over IITs other colleges. Why is that? I get it that, you know, the main reason for you choosing this college is because it's near to your hometown.
Yeah.
But what else, what have you heard about BITS Pilani when you were not in the college? And after entering to college, how was the vibe? How are the faculties? How is the overall genre of the college?
Okay, I'll start with telling what the options I had at that time. So basically I secured All India rank 1013 in JEE mains, and my advanced rank was also quite good. And in the bid set I had secured 364 marks. So at that time I was getting CS in BITS Goa and like every other branch except BITS Pilani CS. So after preparing for JEE and all that, I developed a strong confidence of mathematics. I was like, I can pursue maths. So I chose MSc Mathematics as my dual degree, hoping that I could score good in like the first year of the college and I would make a substitution or like basically we have an option after 1 year, we can opt for engineering degree as well. So I was hoping that I'll get MSc Mathematics plus CS, which was supposed to be the best combination ever in like BITS and in the India, because it is quite good. So that was the plan, but it went horribly wrong. In the first year everything changed, so it was online, so I was not able to concentrate that much on my studies and there were some other things. So I got electronics as like, so but it was okay because after the first year I knew that I cannot do coding, so CS is not for me. So yeah, I was satisfied with my branch. Other than that, the main thing that differentiates BITS Pilani from every other college is the 0% attendance policy. Like it is the best for college students. Like I have personally never go to classes. Like I only go to classes for starting 4-5 lectures and then I skip all those things because we get all the lectures, videos, everything on our like drives, so we can prepare from our home, like from our rooms only. And talking about the faculties are very good. Like I am from electronics and instrumentation, so there are faculties who are very good. Like they know what they are doing, they know how to teach, they know how to make you understand all the concept, they know how to develop your like interest in those specific areas. Because when I joined the electronics department, I was like, I want CS, but after studying electronics now I am an hardcore core electronics fan.
Okay,
yeah.
So amazing, I guess. I didn't know that, you know, they had so now let's talk about the fees of the college. Like what was the fees for your bachelor's program and what's for your master's program, and then we can come to the conclusion for the placements, like, you know, what's the CTC and everything. So firstly let's talk about the fees of the college.
Okay, so after 12th we can join BITS Pilani. We have two options basically. We can either join master's or like master's of science, MSc basically, or either we can join BE, engineering, bachelor's of engineering, or we can go for dual degree, which is MSc plus engineering. So the fees is same for all those things, all these courses, and the fees is around, like at my time it was around 2.5 lakhs a semester tuition fees. Other than that, like we can, at my time it was around 1.5 lakhs a semester tuition fees, hostel fees, mass and other advances. So for a year it should be around 7 to 8 lakhs a year.
For a year?
Yeah.
So for 3 years it would be 25 lakhs, somewhere around 25.
Yeah, matlab we only have courses for either for 4 year or 5 year in after 12.
Mm.
Yeah. But there are other many scholarships going on in the campus. Like there are merit scholarship in which top 1% student get 100% fees off, or like there are merit cum need scholarship in which if your family income is below a specific slab, you get like scholarships based on that.
Okay, so mostly it will be a 4 or 5 year program.
Yeah.
And not everyone gets, you know, scholarship. Like 90% of student will not get scholarship.
Yeah.
So it would be somewhere more than 30 lakhs,
yeah.
I assume. Yeah? Okay. So now let's talk about the placements. What about the placement? Like you have heard from your senior, kya placements ka rehta hai. So like, what's the average CTC that anyone can get in your field? And then we can, if you know, then we can talk about other fields.
See, the trends were very clear before this recession thing. And the average package was around, for CS it was around 27 lakhs, I guess. Overall was around 16 to 18 lakhs. So it was good. But after this recession thing, nobody is sure. Even IT, most of the IITians are unplaced. But comparatively, our placement season was good enough. Like, I don't see people roaming around with no offers. Almost everybody got placed. There are some people who are unplaced, but they are mostly the people who will go for masters or will pursue their like startups and all, because we have a very good startup ecosystem here. So
nice. If you could name a few companies, like few renowned companies who often come to Bitspillana.
I mean, Google is there and IBM is there. In electronics, Nvidia, Texas Instruments is there, IMC Trading is there, and like there are a lot of big companies. Almost all the BCG is there. BCG came to our campus.
Okay.
Exchange.
So I guess overall the placement cell is good, I assume.
Yeah.
Mostly I've heard Bits Pilani ka naam from Ishan Sharma. He was also part of Bits Pilani.
Who?
He dropped out. Ishan Sharma, he's a YouTuber right now.
Okay.
Yeah, he has like 1 million subscribers and he talks about his journey of Bits Pilani and how he dropped out in fourth year, I guess.
So
my last question would be, what advice will you give to someone who is planning to come to Bits Pilani? Like, do you think it's all worth it to spend like 30-40 lakhs for the whole degree? And I guess your experience was great, but let's if you can, you know, just advise to someone who will be coming to Bits Pilani. So what will be that one advice? And my next question would be, what are your plans for now? Like, will you be also planning to go into corporate sector, or you are planning to start something of your own, or like what are your plans?
Okay, so I'll start by giving the advice. So I think Bits Pilani is a very good college. We have a very strong alumni network. The campus is beautiful. The people here are very good and the best. The campus life is excellent. Like, I have visited a lot of IITs and I have not experienced the pleasure or the fun I get in the Bits. Okay. And Bits Pilani don't have reservation kind of thing. So that also helps a lot, because I think in IITs there is some kind of discrimination kind of thing based on that reservation and all. But Bits is quite peaceful. In my 4 years of college life, I have never seen a fight. It is very good. And talking about like how to prepare, so it is very difficult to find resources for BitSet because it is an online examination, so questions are not easily available. But yeah, the level of the questions is comparable to JEE Mains. At least at my time, it was comparable. It was easy, on the easier side only. So you just have to prepare for JEE Mains, and you have to be like confident while giving the paper. That's the main thing. And so talking about my like what I'll do in my future, I'm currently pursuing an internship at TELUS International as a part of my college curriculum. So I am experiencing the corporate life right now, and it's good. But in my future, I think I'll go in PSUs, because I have interest in electronics, mostly instrumentation. So PSUs seems to be a very good option for me.
So I guess this was it. It would be really helpful for everyone who will be watching this video and for everyone who wants to be a part of this college. So thank you so much, Pushpendra, for being a part of this video, and I appreciate your efforts that you instantly, you know, said yes for this. So thank you.